Hello guys, in this tutorial I'm going to show how to convert the SolidWorks model of any robotic arm, any industrial robotic arm into a URDF format, which is Universal Robotic Description format, which is required for simulating any robot in ROS, robot operating system. So for this tutorial I'm going to be using GP7 from Yaksava Robotics. So they have Yaksava is a company that provides a lot of robotic arms. So I'm gonna be using this robotic arm. You can go and download the CAD model from their website for any robotic arm. So I'm using GP7. So I downloaded this 3D model and open it up in SolidWorks. We also might need some specification to convert this. URDF, to convert this CAD model into URDF, these specifications are required maximum speed or maximum angular position or motion range along with the maximum moment or torques. So before converting this CAD model to URDF, which is done by using URDF exporter provided by a project on ROS Industrial, we first need to assign coordinate system to each link in this robotic arm. So if this is a 6 degrees of freedom robotic arm, so it has 7 links. DH parameter says that link 1, first link is link 0 and then link 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. But normally in ROS, the first link is called base link. And then we have link 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And because it's a 6 degrees of freedom, that's why there are 7 links. Connected by 6 joints, and so first we need to assign a coordinate system. Why? Because ROS Industrial, which is an open source project which provides ROS support for a lot of robotic arm, industrial robotic arm, it says that it requires an standardized length and frames assigned to each link of the robot URDF. So we are going to be doing the same. Initially, what happens is that in SolidWorks, the y-axis is always in the upward direction and x-axis is always in the forward direction. But so we need to correct this. So for each link, I've gone ahead and corrected it. So I'll show you for one. In addition to this, we also need to assign axes for each joint. So there is a joint between this and this. Between this link and this link, and it is present in this link, which is the second link, the shoulder link, and we need to assign an axis about which this joint moves. So first I'll show you how to assign frames, which is also coordinate system are also called frames basically. So we right click on it and open the subassembly, and as you can see, I have already assigned a base link here. And along with this link, I have also assigned. Okay, so here I did not assign because it's a static link. The first one. In the second link, you can see that I have assigned a coordinate system along with an axis. Right. So let's go to the first link, the base link, and assign the coordinate system here. So this is the coordinate system that I have assigned here. So as you can see, according to ROS Industrial specification, the x-axis should always be in the forward direction. So if you see on the screen, it should be up in the minus x direction currently, and the z-axis should be upward. So we'll open this again. We will delete this link, this frame. We will select origin, go to reference geometry, and select the coordinate system. So currently the x-axis is in the opposite direction. So we will click on this and it goes up this direction. And y-axis is in the opposite direction. Y-axis is in the upward direction. So we go on the z and select a plane. And if we select top plane, so the normal of the top plane will be the z-axis. So it's z-axis again. But doing so, what happens is x-axis is all again switched back. So we go again to this and select this right plane, and now I think I've messed it up again. So if we clear this and select this, yeah. So as you can see now, x-axis is in the forward direction, y-axis is in the upward direction, and z-axis is in the upward direction, and y-axis is defined according to the right-hand rule. So we change the name of this coordinate system to base length, and naming is actually like, if we name things accordingly, we'll have less problems when we convert this into URDF and we are using this robot in raw simulation, so we'll have less problems here. So if we save this and open up the assembly again and go to the base length, this part, and we can see that here is the base length, and if we zoom into it, we'll see that x-axis is in the forward direction of this robot and z-axis is in the upward direction. So I did the same thing for all the lengths. As you can see, for example, shoulder length or shoulder joint, there is x-axis is always in the forward direction, z-axis is in the upward direction. Similarly, for this, it's in the forward direction and upward direction. Then for the last, we have to do the same. X is in the forward and Z is upward. Doing so, what happens is basically we have a consistency in the frame. DH parameter, and following DH convention, we don't have actually, if you follow the DH convention, we do not have consistency, and it's a little confusing when we are simulating the robot. Okay. Now, because like in DH convention, what happens is that every axis around which the joint moves, it's called z-axis. But here, because we assign coordinate system arbitrarily and according to a specification, so this this joint does not move around z-axis. It basically moves around its y-axis according to this coordinate frame, length s coordinate frame. So in addition to this, we also need to assign an axis which tells it where it moves. Oh, sorry, it moves according to this, but if we look at this joint, so it should move, this should move around y-axis, so this axis shows that it moves around y-axis. So assigning axis is similar. We, for example, if we select this link S, and we open, and we know that it moves. If we talk with reference to this this global coordinate system of SolidWorks, this joint should move about y-axis, right? So we need to assign an axis to it, which is in upper direction. So I already assigned it, but I'll show you how to do it. So we'll open this sub-assembly, and here we have this axis. I'll delete it. So the motor will be connected here in this part, and its axis should be concentric to it. Concentric, or like, should be going from the center of the circle. So we need to assign an axis here. So what we can do is we select origin, and then we go ahead, select an axis from the reference geometry, and we need to select a plane. So the axis should be the normal of this plane. So it's the top plane, and we select OK, and here it is now. So we will also change the name of it from axis 3 to axis _, and the name of the length, which is S. And by the way, this SL length name comes from the Yaksava. So they use first joint as S, second as L, U, R, B, and T, because they have their name, length, upper arm, lower arm, shoulder, tool. So yeah. So I save this, and if I go back, and so here we have the axis and the frame. I did this for all of them. Now to export this robot as URDF, you go and you say export as URDF. Probably you don't have this already, so you'll have to install this package for SolidWorks. Google it and you'll find it probably. And you can click on export. Now we need to do some configuration here. So URDF is the markup language which has a parent-child relationship. So, and because this is a serial robotic arm, so it also has a parent-child relationship. So the first parent is basically a static base. I'll call, and the link zero is always static. In ROS, link zero is called base link. So this is why the first link is called base link. This is under global origin coordinate system. We will select base link CS, which we assigned previously. In the link component, we'll have to select the whole assembly for the base link, which is this part. So you see this part is selected, and it has one number of child, which is the link one. So I'll select one link, and when I click outside of this, so you see this an empty link pops up in this screen. If I select empty link, then now I have to change the link name. So here we have to follow a convention. In ROS, we do link underscore S, where S is the name of this link underscore one because it's the first link. Similarly, join for joint name, we say joint underscore S underscore one. So this standard is more or less a standard from ROS Industrial. And it's nice to follow standards because it makes your life easier while simulation and while working with real robot. Similarly, for reference coordinate system, we have to select link SCS. This link SCS, you can see, is basically from this coordinate system if I hover my mouse over it. Similarly, it automatically selected the reference coordinates. For reference axis, I have to select axis underscore S, which is basically this. And for joint type, I'll have to select revolute because it's a revolute joint. For link component, I'll have to select this whole assembly. And it has a one number of child, which is basically the next link. And it's one. If I say one and click, it will pop another one. I'll have to do the same for all the six links. So I'll do it and then unpause the video. So I've gone ahead and done and made this tree. So you can see this is the first join. We have selected the second join. We have selected the proper reference coordinate system, reference axis, join type. Similarly for join 2, link 2 basically, link 3, link 4, link 5. And because link 6 is the tool, so you follow this is the link 6 at which you can add any gripper, and it has zero child currently, so I just add zero child. And here is the point where our parent child relationship ends, or our tree ends, and then we can do load configuration, no sorry preview and export. And it will take a minute to generate URDF, so bear with me. So once you click on preview and export, you'll have this configuration join properties. So here we have to configure every join properties. For example, we have to provide the limits of each join. We can also provide the dynamics, for example, friction and damping. Safety controller, we can provide soft limits. Soft upper limit and lower limit means that, for example, if your robot goes from 180 to 0 degrees, soft and upper lower limit can be 5 degrees to 175 degrees. So, because it's just a demo, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to say lower limit 1 and upper limit minus 1, or probably I'll just pause the video and fill this up. So we can find these values from Yaksava specification. So as you can see here, they have provided the maximum range of motion for each robot. So this is GP7, so plus minus 170 degrees, and similarly all of these. But the problem is that we need to put it in radians, not in degrees. So I'll have to convert them and then put it here. So I'll do it and then unpause the video and show you how it's done. So yeah. So as you can see that I have filled up these values. For example, joint 1 has the limit from plus minus 170. So lower limit is minus 170. So I converted it into radians and put it here. There is no value for effort and velocity in this chart. So what I did is basically, there is for speed. So I'll fill it up. Degree to radian. And it's 375. It's just 375. We'll just copy it and put it in. So it's almost similar for first three joints. So it's not noted yet, so I'll just put it here. Paste. For now, because it's a simulation, so I'll just copy the same stuff here. And for this, I mean, you should the specification, but for now I'm just gonna put 30 newton in each of them. I'm guessing 30 newton because for other last three joints they provided the allowable torque, which is 17 17 and 10, which I have put it here 17 17 and 10. Okay, so another thing to notice is that all the joint types are revolute, which is correct. And the joint name, it should be like this, as we have talked about it. There is no mimic joint. We don't need to provide the friction and damping as of now, because first we don't know what the friction or damping is going to be. You don't have to mess with this origin part of it. And once this is done, once you have provided the limits, and these axes are according to this coordinate system and this axis, so you don't have to change this at all. We can go ahead and click next. Here we have to provide inertia and all the other things, but if you don't have if you don't know these values, it's not necessary to provide them. And you can just go ahead and click on export URDF and meshes. So we have to export the meshes again in STL format, but currently we'll just do export. We'll do export URDF. So I'll just make a folder here, GP25 underscore description, and here to write GP25 robot. Okay, and it will export the necessary file into URDF. The video is almost 20 minutes. I did not expect it to be this long. So I'll just pause it until it exports. As you can see that it exported as in this folder. There are a lot of folders here, config, launch, meshes, textures, URDF, and other. So these meshes are the STL meshes which for each link. There are 7 links, so these are 7 files. And then there is this your robot URDF file, which is like automatically generated. And this is the joint config file. So if we open this in Visual Studio, we can see that URDF file looks like this. It's a markup language. So So there are, or there are connections between each link and with joins. And in the next video, I'll show you how to open up and simulate this in Gazebo, which is physics engines for ROS, and how to play with that and simulate that. So subscribe to my channel, like this video, and share it if possible. Thank you so much. Bye.